Well, hello everybody. Here is a really quick video to talk about insulin. And I'm doing this in response to a video that I saw on YouTube by a doctor with a channel who talks a lot about nutrition. And somebody, one of my followers sent me this and asked me the question, what do I think? And there was one aspect of this video that I just found absolutely shocking. And that was the recommendation that we eat quite a lot of carbohydrates. He was talking about how it matters where the carbohydrates come from, which I don't agree with, because once you digest it, your body has no idea where it came from. Glucose is glucose. But saying that insulin, which we know rises when we take in sugars, and talking about how important insulin is, and therefore you must eat sugar so that your body releases insulin, because you need insulin. Insulin is a growth hormone, and insulin has a role in something like 100 different processes in your body. That's all true, but you don't need sugar to be able to produce insulin. That is a complete nonsense conclusion. For starters, when you eat protein, your insulin goes up too. Now, not as much as it does when you eat glucose. The protein effect on your insulin is probably less than half what the glucose effect is. But it does cause a slight rise in insulin. So you don't have to have sugar to be able to produce insulin, but your body will produce the insulin it needs according to the demands and what is needed from time to time. And it may be to do with what you're eating, or it may have nothing at all to do with your eating. Eating is not the only thing that triggers the release of insulin. The reason you produce so much insulin when you eat sugar is exactly because your body has to get rid of the sugar, because it's toxic. Sugar in your bloodstream is toxic over about 5 milligrams, and it's very easy to eat more than 5 milligrams of sugar. You just have a slice of cake and you've probably got 40 or 50 or 60 milligrams of sugar. So it's got to be disposed of. So insulin is the only way you can get rid of it. And insulin will force it into the muscle cells to be burnt, or it will send it back to the liver to say, get rid of this toxic stuff. Because that's what your liver does. Your liver is your detox organ. So it's rubbish. You don't have to eat sugar in order to make sure you don't become insulin deficient. That is absolute, utter garbage. We know that diabetes, type 2 diabetes, is caused by eating too much carbohydrate, by eating too much sugar. Everyone knows diabetes is a sugar disease. You have a lot of glucose in your blood, therefore you produce a lot of insulin, you produce too much insulin, your body eventually becomes deaf to the insulin, and it leads to your pancreas actually not being able to produce enough insulin anymore, and then you become diabetic. So eating sugars is not essential. In fact, for anything, never mind for insulin production, it's not useful. It's not a constructive compound. You're not built out of sugars. You don't need sugars in your body for anything at all, except a tiny, tiny, tiny amount in your blood to keep your brain functioning correctly. And your body will do that by itself. Now, it's very difficult to eat no sugar, because it hides in things, and if you cut sugar out of your diet, you're going to get a little bit anyway, and you'll be fine. But even if you don't, your liver will just make the tiny bit that is needed for your brain. Most of your brain can operate on ketones, which is the fuel, the burnable compound that comes from eating fat. So no, we do not need sugar to be able to produce insulin. Yes, insulin is important, but your body will regulate your insulin levels in a healthy way when you don't eat carbohydrates or sugar. Thank you for subscribing to this channel. Please share this with anybody who might have seen that and thinks maybe that you really do have to have a couple of 100 grams of sugar in your diet every day, because you absolutely don't. You are messing with your insulin levels and you are playing with fire.